Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to today's product review for this pinsound Bluetooth stereo speaker system. Now it's marketed in the UK by a company called Easy SMX and they advertise the product on amazon.co.uk. Let's have a look at the product and I'll take you through some of the features of the product itself. It comes in the standard cardboard box, quite attractively printed. There are a couple of mistakes on the actual product description. It does say, for example, that you get an AC charging unit that isn't supplied with this unit. You're just supplied with a USB to micro USB charging cable for the device. There is no AC adapter in the box. So that is the first mistake on the product itself. Inside the box, it's quite well protected. We've got these foam sheets which protect the device from scratches. It does come with a set of polythene bags around each of the products, but I've removed those obviously to test the device. You also get a multi-language instruction pamphlet. The print is quite small. I normally would have to use glasses to read something this small, but you can actually work out the operation of the unit without the instructions. It's quite self-explanatory. The unit itself does contain a lithium ion battery, which has a capacity of 2200 mAh, according to the specifications. I fully discharged this and charged it using a portable power meter, and I got 3600 mAh. So it could be a higher capacity battery that's been installed in this unit. I am not quite sure on that. The device itself supports two 2-inch loudspeakers and two 2-inch reflectors. Interestingly, the design of the unit has one speaker facing forward and the other speaker facing backwards, and the interconnected reflectors then redirect the sound front and back. So you do get the stereo on both sides. So you've got 360 degrees worth of sound pattern. It's rated at 2 by 5 watts stereo power, so that's 5 watts RMS, so you'll get slightly higher peak values. But it's interesting that the device will run for about 5 hours on mid-volume. I actually got extended run times of 12 hours on about a third volume. So you will get longer run times with reduced power. It's Bluetooth 4.2 compatible, so it does support all the latest protocols, the A2DP, the Advanced Analog Digital Protocol, so you can actually use the forward and reverse keys to skip forward and skip back your tracks if your device supports that. If you've got a device that doesn't support Bluetooth but supports 3.5 audio output, then there is a port on the side here which allows you to use the included cable to connect to your device over the analog system. You can switch from Bluetooth to the analog input by a simple depress of a button on top. I'll mention that when we come back to the feature set. You get a charging cable, which is a USB to micro USB charging cable. It's about a meter long. That does present you with some problems with the voltage drop in the actual cable, reducing the amount of charge current. What I would recommend is you use a smaller charging cable like this one, which has got a thicker conductor inside. And I've gone from just over 600 milliamps to 1.2 amps charging with the shorter lead. So you'll get a double rate of charge, so you're half the time that it takes to charge this unit. So it's worth investing in a proper charging cable. The other point to note in the internet, the Amazon webpage, it does specify this is for iPhone only, that it will charge on the iPhone devices from the USB output device on the side. That's not the case. I've been charging my Sony Xperia Z3 and this Samsung Galaxy Tab 2 from the USB output, but it won't charge those devices using the included micro USB cable. This cable doesn't support the right number of cables to give you the right protocol. If you use a dedicated charging cable or the cable that's supplied with your device, you'll find that the USB output will charge those Android devices. So the information on the Amazon webpage appears to be incorrect in that respect. I've got up to 1.2 amps charging from this device with the Samsung Galaxy and with the Xperia Z smartphone. Charging is done by the micro USB port, so you'll use your charging lead and your own external AC adapter, or you can charge it from any other USB charging port. So look at the top of the unit. We have the power on off button, which is used to activate the device and start up the Bluetooth pairing, which is an automatic feature. We've got the skip forward and skip back keys, which are there to use the forward and back track facility, supported over Bluetooth, but not obviously if you're using the analog connection cable. And the volume up and down keys to increase the volume from the amplifier within this device. Pause and play button, again for your Bluetooth device. The button here to switch from Bluetooth to the 3.5 audio input. Over on the right hand side here, you will see the LEDs which indicate the state of charge of the device. And then you've got the Bluetooth indicator. A rapid flashing means that it's in its pairing mode, and a slow flash means that it's being paired with your host device, and a green LED which indicates you're using the 3.5 audio input. Let's power it up and you can see those LEDs in operation. To power it on, just press and hold the power button for about 2 seconds, and you notice now we've got three indicators which show that this device is fully charged. The blue LED is rapidly flashing, which means that this device is trying to find a host device. It can remember up to 8 devices that you've paired previously, so it will hold 8 Bluetooth host devices. So it's now looking for a device to pair to, and if I turn on my iPhone 5S here and we go to the Bluetooth settings, in the list of devices available it appears as the FUL SPB75 device. So the device is rapidly flashing, so if I ask the smartphone to pair with it just by clicking on that, the device will pair automatically. No need to enter any passcodes to enable the two devices to be connected. So the device is now connected, so we have a slow steady blue LED, which means that the device is connected. I'm not going to play any commercial music which would violate copyright, but I do have a previous audio recording I made earlier this morning of the device, so I'm going to play that.
This is the pinsound portable Bluetooth speaker system marketed by easysmx.com.
So that's just an audio recording made using an application on the smartphone. So you can see the quality is okay. I've been using this with piano music and the tone is quite good. I listen to a lot of audio podcasts. Again, for speech, the tone is quite good. You can use this at quite high volume. So if you're going to use this at parties, barbecues, outdoor activities, there is sufficient volume in this unit to allow you to do that. But obviously you'll reduce the runtime of the battery under those situations. So with the controls, if I wanted to change over to the audio input from 3.5 millimeters, then I just need to press briefly the M button, and that now changes over from Bluetooth. We'll disconnect the Bluetooth pairing and we'll switch over to the manual input on the side of the 3.5 millimeter jack. Obviously, if you want to use Bluetooth, it will pair with any Bluetooth host. I've connected this to my laptop so I can use it as an external speaker. If you've got a television which supports Bluetooth, you can actually use this as an external speaker to your television system. So something like soundbars, which may operate on Bluetooth, you can actually use this as an external device. I've been using this to charge my travel zoom camera. So when I go away and camping next week, I'll be using this device not only to listen to some podcasts while I'm camping, but also to charge up my travel zoom camera from the port. Remembering that it's only 2,200 milliamp hour battery, so you'll only get one full charge of an iPhone perhaps, or two or three charges for the camera. But obviously you're going to be charging this on the go as well, so in the car when I'm going from location to location, I can top this up as we go along. The device does come with a faux leather carry strap, so if you wanted to use this with a carry strap, you can assemble this faux leather strap. It's got a plain leather front and a simulated leather rear. It's fitted to the device by just sliding it through the slots on the side of the speaker. Line up the two holes, you've got a large headed thumb screw and a smaller one. So the larger one goes from the front, and the smaller one is just screwed into the rear of this thumb screw to lock it in place. Obviously, you fit the hand strap on the other side as well, and you've got a convenient carry strap for the device. You'll also notice here on the top of the unit we've got a simulated wooden fascia, and that adds to the complete retro styling of this unit. It's available in gold and in silver if you wanted to take silver as your preference. So they are a nice multifunctional device which I like. You've got the facility to play music or podcasts, you've got the facility to power your phone while you're playing that podcast or music, or you can charge external units from the internal battery, which I really do like. For a full review of this product, I actually took this unit apart to have a look at the build quality and also the health and safety aspects around the lithium-ion battery that's incorporated in this device. Obviously with lithium-ion, it's important that that battery does have protection circuits so that you can't overcharge or over-discharge it. You don't want this device to be bursting into flames as you're charging it. So I can report that from my investigations with the device, it does appear to have the correct charging circuit and protection built onto that lithium-ion battery. So I've got no concerns about recommending the product from a health and safety point of view. The actual build quality is quite good. You can see from the picture on screen now, the surface mount components are well placed, and there doesn't appear to be any problems with the electronic construction of the device. Fairly standard circuitry, Bluetooth module here on the top right hand side, and the necessary audio amplifiers to drive the loudspeakers, and the battery protection circuit and charging circuits, and the output port for the 5 volt charging of your external devices. So everything's built onto that one main circuit board, I've got no concerns about any of that construction technique. Obviously you wouldn't want to open your own unit, you would invalidate the warranty, and it does carry some risk of short circuiting that lithium battery. So I've done that so you know what's inside the unit, as I'm a trained electronics technician, so I know exactly what I'm doing with these devices. So there we are, that's the product review. Thanks very much for watching. If you're a new viewer to the channel, please do click that like button and the subscribe button, and you'll be notified when I upload new videos to this channel. Also check out my photographic blog, you'll find lots more information on photography, and in particular Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras, and there'll also be a slight review of this product on my travel zoom page, as I'm using this to charge travel zoom cameras. So until my next video, thanks very much for watching. Until then, please do take care. Bye for now.